I did include some posts in my motion for gag order against Mr. Phillips. I would note for the court that Mr. Phillips last, yesterday, posted on Facebook that there was going to be this hearing this morning, and he posted both my motion for gag order and his response to my motion for gag order. Your Honor, the case law is clear in this area that where someone's First Amendment right confronts with a client's Sixth Amendment right in a criminal case, that the Sixth Amendment right can control and should control. My client has a right to a fair trial here. Again, since the inception of this case, Mr. Phillips has gone to the media and claimed that both the state attorney is not doing their job, the courts are not doing their job, my client, he's poisoned the panel and the veneer with different Snapchats and things that are maybe admissible, maybe not admissible in the trial regarding my client, regarding in his press conference, he held up large pictures of Snapchats that indicated my client was squashed. He tried to indicate when those posts were made. Again, this is serves no purpose in his discovery, which Mr. Phillips is claiming that he doesn't want the gag order to be issued because it violates his rights to discovery in the civil case. It does nothing to further that, to disseminate these alleged posts to the constituency of our area in the panel that my client would presumably draw a jury from. Your Honor, in going straight to his response, he does note that we do have a rule governing trial publicity and that prejudicial extrajudicial statements are prohibited. And it says, a lawyer shall not make an extrajudicial statement that a reasonable person would expect to be disseminated by means of a public communication if the lawyer knows or reasonably should know that it will have a substantial likelihood of materiality or materially prejudicing an adjudicative proceeding due to its creation of an imminent and substantial detrimental effect on that proceeding. That's exactly what Mr. Phillips is doing here. While in his response, he claims to the court that this court doesn't have authority to issue a gag order on him. The court does. He is a lawyer in the state of Florida, and this court has authority over all lawyers in the state of Florida to ensure my client's right to a fair trial. And when an attorney's speech impedes on my client's Sixth Amendment right to a fair trial, this court has not only the authority, but the duty to ensure that my client's right to a fair trial is preserved. Further, Your Honor, again, he states that it doesn't apply to private attorneys of the victim, but again, the rule has no caveat for private attorneys. It says lawyer, and he is his leading lawyer. He states the relief I saw is premature. It is not premature. It's ongoing. Again, he just Facebooked about this case and this gag order last night on Facebook. Again, that does nothing to further his discovery in the civil matter. Only seeks to poison the jury panel. And to that end, Your Honor, I would cite to Mr. Phillips' own response on page 9, where Mr. Phillips includes a total non sequitur in the gag order and writes, the undersigned firm also represents another plaintiff in a separate incident where it appears Dasher untruthful, which he then disseminated to everyone who follows his Facebook post last night. So not only has he placed this in the public record in this case, but then he's further gone and disseminated it through Facebook to anyone who follows him on Facebook, however many hundreds, thousands, etc. of people those are. He states that my client made apparent misrepresentations and is somehow inferring that my client tricked the person in that case to accept a lower or nothing settlement because my client allegedly lied. Again, that has nothing to do with my motion for the gag order, but only seeks to underline why I'm asking for a gag order specifically against Mr. Phillips, because all he is doing is trashing my client in the media to his detriment and to my client's detriment and to, you know, hinder his ability to receive a fair trial. Again, he states that this will cause him to commit legal malpractice because he can't do discovery. I'm not asking the court to gag his discovery ability. He is certainly allowed to talk to witnesses. He is certainly allowed to get any public records that the state provides in this case in discovery. But, Your Honor, what he's not allowed to do, again, is trample a fair trial. And the second thing I, or the first thing I provided, Your Honor, was an article from WPDF Online. And in that article, they discussed, because of Mr. Phillips' incessant posting and press conferences stating that the state attorney in this circuit was not doing their job by arresting Mr. Dashner immediately, or somehow inferring that my client was getting special treatment because of who his father is, the fire department in our area was receiving multiple threats, and the sheriff had to escort our fire department on multiple calls because of the credibility of the threats from this case, which I think is directly, again, attributable to Mr. Phillips posting on social media and discussions with social media. Further, in that same article, Your Honor, Mr. Phillips states, and I quote, Tanner Dashner is still driving in Fort Pierce, and if he had been okay, if he had walked away from that, he would have been arrested immediately for DUI. So he has the privilege, because he had such a bad wreck and went to the hospital, he essentially got an extra 20 days, including today, to be able to drive, and that's horrifying. End quote. That's a statement that Mr. Phillips made. There can be no argument by Mr. Phillips or anyone that a reasonable lawyer would not know or reasonably should know that that statement that my client's driving after a quintuple DUI alleged manslaughter, that it has a substantial likelihood of materially prejudicing the proceeding before this court. He definitely knew. There's no way that a reasonable lawyer would not know that saying my client allegedly driving after this occurred is going to poison the jury panel. That's his intent. That's what he's trying to do. He's trying to, I think, poison the panel in his favor for a potential civil suit. But what that is doing is poisoning our veneer for the criminal trial. And again, that applies against our client's Sixth Amendment right. Mr. Phillips states that there is no precedent for this. Of course there is. And I know that the court just, just as recently as February 15th of this year, a federal court for the United States District Court of Columbia filed a gag order against Roger Stone's lawyers. All the lawyers in that case were gagged because of statements made to the media. And they cite to the United States Supreme Court case Gentile v. State Bar in Nevada, 501 U.S. 1030 from 1991. And it states, because lawyers have special access to information through discovery and client communications, their extrajudicial statements pose a threat to the fairness of a pending proceeding. They also further go on to say, the Supreme Court noted, the limitations are aimed at two principal evils. One, comments that are likely to influence the actual outcome of the trial. And two, comments that are likely to prejudice the jury veneer, even if an untainted panel can ultimately be found. Few, if any, interests under the Constitution are more fundamental than the right to a fair trial by impartial jurors, and an outcome affected by extrajudicial statements would violate that fundamental right. Your Honor, in light of this, in light of the United States Supreme Court case law that supports this, I would ask the court, again, because of it is impeding on my client's Sixth Amendment right to a fair trial, I would specifically ask to gag John Phillips' extrajudicial statements that he should know or reasonably should know have the likelihood of impacting my client's right to a fair trial. I'd ask that same order be placed upon the state attorney's office, upon Florida Highway Patrol, and on my office.
Okay, Mr. White.
Judge, there is no one from the state attorney's office that is going to pre-try this case in the media, social media, or anywhere else. We plan on trying this case in the courtroom. Florida Highway Patrol, I believe, is the same thing. They are not going to make these statements. So I don't think there's any issue there. I really think this is an issue between the defense and Mr. Phillips. And I would say that the state really has no dog in this fight. I will say this, though, because the motion does include all agents of the state attorney's office. In no way, shape, or form is Mr. Phillips an agent to the state attorney's office. So if he does something, I don't want it to come back to the state of Florida. We are doing our thing. He can do his own, but he is not an agent.
Okay. In All right, well, as I understand the case law, the justification for such an order needs to be that the statements made by counsel or their parties pose a substantial or imminent threat to a fair trial. And I don't think there's been a sufficient showing at this point.